So what are the biological roles or functions of glycans? And if I were to use one slide to hit home something that we needed whole organism genetics to get us to and appreciate, if you had a mutation or if you knocked in genes that were responsible for carbohydrate assembly or carbohydrate synthesis, this picture is worth 1,000 words. It's essentially the most dramatic picture of a similar locus where alterations in the carbohydrate structure on the protein that displace these polysaccharides, if you will, on cell surfaces, give you very dramatically different phenotype. Obviously, the question is, how do we get to the molecular basis of this, try to really understand what are the fundamental roles in these processes, and to be able to understand the structure-function relationship. So it gets us to the sort of the central molecular picture. And what I'd like to do is frame the central role of polysaccharide using the molecular dogma, if you will, of how DNA makes RNA makes protein. And we thought that we understood much of life and genomics was the answer to a lot of the basic questions, which is true in some sense in terms of understanding pathways. But if you truly look at it, one of the things that you see with regard to proteins is the fact that the most extensive form of post-translation modification of proteins is glycosylation, or the process of attaching carbohydrates to proteins, because you're able to get a huge amount of functional diversity. What do I mean by that? Using erythropoietin, which is a biologic, it's a protein that essentially plays a central role in how red blood cells are replenished, you begin to see that one EPO molecule, one protein molecule, has greater than 150 unique different carbohydrate structures attached to it. And that begs the question, how do these molecules impinge on the functionality of erythropoietin, and what are the functional consequences of this, these kinds of attachments? So it is fair to say that as a consequence of our understanding of these carbohydrates attached to proteins, the fact that you have one gene, one protein, and many glycoproteins, the central dogma has truly been revisited in the sense that you're now able to get a huge amount of functional diversity by using a combination of these different carbohydrates that are attached to proteins so that you can get a diversity on the function. And as I walk through some of these examples, you'll begin to see why the role of these kinds of modification eventually play a role in biological function. Very simply put, there are two broad families of carbohydrates. One, which are branched, and I'm going to very quickly summarize. The other, which are linear, which I'll summarize in the next slide. And building on the previous slide, one of the things you begin to see is the fact that glycosylation is the most extensive form of post-translation modification that I just mentioned. And these are determinants of recognition function, protein folding, targeting, half-life, and stability and specificity. So the question is, how do you assemble these? How do you know where they are modified, and hence how they're going to affect the functional attributes of a protein? But in reality, the sites and structures and the abundances of glycans on a given protein have only been established for a handful of glycoproteins. So you can begin to appreciate that we're at the early stages of this field, truly trying to understand what the functional consequences of these modifications are, given the fact that we're just beginning to access what the various glycans are on different proteins, such as erythropoietin. If you actually look at the following point, which is if you take the top 9 of the 10 protein-based biotherapeutic products that are used in the clinic, they're glycosylated. They have sugars attached to them, and they have functional consequences in the way these sugar molecules function. So part of trying to understand protein function, you truly need to get to access the carbohydrates and how these carbohydrates are attached to proteins.